testing elbow flexion against gravity position. Patient will be in a seated position with arm resting comfortably at side. What you will have your patient first do is perform full elbow flexion. Go ahead and do that for me. Bring it back down. Because she's able to do this, I know that she's at least a 3. Now, when you test elbow flexion, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be testing for 3 different muscles, the biceps brachii, the brachioradialis, and the brachialis. To first do the biceps brachii, you will have your patient's palm facing forward, and when she comes up, she will kind of be in a spoon, like, you know, kind of lifting something up in that motion. So go ahead and do that for me and come back down. So that's a 3 for that muscle. Come up about halfway. I'm going to stabilize the humerus and apply resistance just proximal to the wrist. So resist me, 3, 2, 1, go back down. Now I will test for the brachioradialis. Thumb in the air. So full range of motion, go ahead and do that for me. So once again, that's a 3. Come up halfway, stabilize, resist me 3 seconds, 3, 2, 1, go back down, and the brachialis will be palm down. Come up with the palm down, full range of motion, back down, that is a 3 once again, come up halfway, stabilize, humerus, press down, 3, 2, 1, depending on her resistance against me, I will rate her a 4 or 5 for each one of those muscles. Testing elbow flexion, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a seated position, arm and forearm fully supported as shown here. When testing for this, we will be testing 3 different muscles. We will be testing the biceps brachii, the brachioradialis, and the brachialis. First, we'll start with the biceps brachii. Her thumb will be pointed towards the ceiling and she will simply perform elbow flexion while in this position. So go ahead and perform elbow flexion for me as far as you can go. And bring it on back. Because she was able to perform elbow flexion at all, we would grade that as a 2. If she could not, I would palpate right here on the biceps brachii. If I feel this muscle firing, that'd be a 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that'd be a 0. Next one is the palm will be flat, and then she will this one will be the brachioradialis. Go ahead and perform elbow flexion for me. And then bring it back. Because she's able to perform that range of motion at all, that would be a 2. If she could not perform that range of motion, then I would palpate just distal to the cubital fossa right here. I would be palpating the brachioradialis. If I feel this muscle firing, that'd be a 1. If I do not feel it firing, that'd be a 0. For the final one, I will have the palm inverted facing outward. So go ahead, it's kind of an awkward position. And then this is for the brachialis. So go ahead and bend your elbow again for me, please. And now bring it back. Once again, any range of motion while in gravity eliminated position would be a 2. If she could not do any range of motion with that, then I will palpate for the brachialis, which is just distal to the biceps tendon right here, right about the crease of the elbow. If I feel this muscle firing, that would be a 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that it will be a 0. Testing elbow extension against gravity position. Patient will be in a supine position with the shoulder at 90 degrees, elbow fully flexed. So bring that up for me, there you are. Now while in this position, I'm going to ask her to fully extend her elbow outward. So go ahead and do that. And now bring it back down. Because she's able to do that against gravity, that is going to be at least a 3. Now I want you to come about halfway for me. I'm going to apply resistance on her forearm just proximal to the wrist and stabilize the scapula down here. So I want you to resist me 3, 2, 1, and then let back down. But according to how much you resist me, I'm going to classify that as a 4 or a 5. Testing elbow extension, gravity eliminated position. Patient will be in a seated position with the arm supported as shown here. What you'll have your patient do is perform a full elbow extension to the best of their ability. So go ahead, do that, and then come back. If there's any extension that is seen here, that is going to be at least a 2. If there is no movement, then I will palpate for the triceps brachii found here. If I feel this muscle firing, that is going to be a grade 1. If I do not feel it firing, that is going to be a grade 0. Testing forearm pronation and supination in a against gravity position. Patient will be seated, shoulder neutral. Make sure that the elbow is at 90 degrees and tucked by your side, because if you extend it outward, you will no longer be testing so much for forearm pronation. So just keep that in mind as you do that with your patients. What you will have your patient is in first in neutral position and have them pronate first. So go ahead and pronate for me, please. Come back. Because she's able to do that, I will rate her as a 3. Now I will apply resistance to test for a 4 or a 5. I will stabilize here at the humerus, and I will grab here just proximal to the wrist. So go ahead and go into pronation again. I will resist you. Okay, come back. Because she was able to give me good resistance, I can rate her as a 4 or a 5. Now go into supination for me as far as you can go. Now back. I'll rate that as a 3 once again, and I will add resistance to the exact same places. So stabilize here at the humerus, add resistance here proximal to the wrist. Go ahead, supinate for me. I'll add resistance, come on back. Once again, rate her as a 4 or a 5. Testing forearm pronation and supination in a gravity limited position. Patient will be seated, arm at 90 degrees, elbow at 90 degrees. Comfortably resting, of course. First thing you will have your patient do is have their forearm supinated first. We are first testing pronation. So while they're in supination, you will ask them to rotate their palm facing away from them. So go ahead and do that for me, please. Because she's able to do this, we know that she's at least a 2. If she could not do this, if there's no movement whatsoever, then I will palpate for the pronator teres, which is found just about right here. There, now you can see it a little better. If I feel this muscle firing, that is going to be a 1. If I do not feel it firing, that is going to be a 0. To test for the supinator, I will have her pronated to begin with, so palm facing away from her, and then I will ask her to bring her palm towards her. So go ahead and do that for me, please. Once again, any movement whatsoever, that is going to be a 2, as she just demonstrated. If there's no movement, I will want to palpate for the supinator, but this muscle is deep, and it is very difficult to get to.